Welcome back. So today we are going to discuss Gomez's Law, the tough law. So this is also one of the important questions. So in this chapter, so once remember that one. So what is the Gomez's Law? So Gomez's Law statement in here. So what is the statement of Gomez's Law? The force of attraction of repulsion between two charges is directly proportional to magnitude of product of the two charges and is inversely proportional to square of their distance. So that is the statement of Ohm's law. So what is the mathematical form of Ohm's law? F is equal to force F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R. So this is the mathematical form of Ohm's law. So here, so Ohm's law in vector form. So here A bar is a vector. So A bar is a vector, it can be written as modulus A bar into A cap. So modulus A is representing magnitude of A vector. So A cap is the unit vector. So here, for example, if we take two charges, Q1 and Q2 separated by certain distance smaller in free space. So two charges are separated by certain distance smaller in free space. Okay, so now, charge Q1 position vector is R1. Charge Q2 position vector is R2. Okay. So first of all, force on second charge. Force on second charge due to first charge. That is F21. F21 means force on second charge. Force on second charge due to first charge due to first charge Q1. Force on second charge due to first charge. So here both are same charges, either positive positive or negative negative. So force of repulsion is there. So in what condition repulsion is formed? So same charges. So opposite charges can now use modular attract on each other. So here, so force on second charge due to first charge, that is F21. So acting along this way. Okay. So at the same time, so force on first charge due to second charge acting in this direction. So next F12. So force on Q1 due to Q2. So these two are equal magnitude but are in opposite direction. So therefore, so F12 bar is equal to minus F21 bar. So F12 bar is equal to minus F21 bar. So now if we take the magnitude, so modulus of F12 bar is equal to modulus of F21 bar. So now calculate the Ohm's law in vector form. Okay, so here, so once observed clearly, so this is very, very important. So if you take the charges Q1 and Q2 separated by certain distance smaller than this space. So here, A are working. Okay, so A are working. So first of all, so R1 is the position vector of the particle Q1. So Q1 position vector is to R1. So Q2 position vector is to R2. Okay, so force on second charge due to first charge. So it is possible, here it refers to force. So this is F21 bar. So next to force on first charge due to second charge. So it is possible, So these two are equal magnitude but are in opposite direction. You know that. So Ohm's law is followed by the Newton's circle of motion. So every action is equal and opposite reaction. So F12 is equal to minus F21. So these two are equal magnitude but are in opposite direction. So now, so these two charges separated by certain distance smaller. So how to write A bar vector, that is Ohm's law in vector form. So force on second charge due to first charge, what is the value? F21 bar. So F21 bar is equal to, so two charges separated by certain distance by applicable of the Ohm's law. So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square, Q1 Q2 by R square into, so this is, so a charge move from force on second charge due to first charge. So like this. So this is R12. So R12 is equal to R2 minus R. So R2 minus R. So otherwise, so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 2 pi R square into R capital. So this is R. Okay. So over here, Q1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 2 pi R square into R capital. So what is the unit vector? R cap is equal to modulus R divided by, so R bar divided by, so R bar divided by modulus R. So R cap is equal to R bar divided by modulus R. So that means it is the ratio of the vector to magnitude of the load vector. It is the ratio of the vector to magnitude of the load vector. So here R cap is equal to R bar divided by modulus R. So by substituting the equation, so F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square into, so R bar divided by modulus R. So modulus R is equal to, this is mod magnitude of R. So magnitude of R is equal to R. So R into R square, R cube. So therefore, F21 vector is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R cube into R. So this is the Coulomb's law in vector. So F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R cube into R. Okay. So this is the Coulomb's law in vector. So sometimes it is a huge amount. Okay, so this is also Coulomb's law in vector form. So F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square into R cap. So A bar is a vector. So how to write the magnitude of the vector to A cap? So this is the magnitude of the Coulomb's law. So this is R cap of the unit vector. So how to write the unit vector? So the ratio of the vector to magnitude of the whole vector. So the ratio of the vector, it is defined as the ratio of the vector to magnitude of the whole vector. So that is called the Coulomb's. So this is the Coulomb's law in vector form. So R cap is equal to R bar by modulus R bar. So next one. So similarly, so we have to work. So F21, value is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square into R cap. So next is F12. So F12 is equal to, so if you use directly 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by, so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square into R cap. R square into R cap. So here, so it is clear. So F21 acting in this stretch. F12 is acting in this stretch. So these are equal magnitude but are in opposite direction. So F12 is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square into R. So here, so F12 vector is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by V. So R goes into R. So this is Coulomb's law in vector. So F12 is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R into R. So this is also Coulomb's law in vector form. So what is Coulomb's law in vector form? F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square into R. So here F12 is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R cube into R. So these two are equal magnitude but are in opposite direction. So this is Coulomb's law in vector. So next one. So we next to say, so the same condition. So if we discuss the another method. So this is also keep on your mind. So if you follow any one method, so if you select any one unusual method. Okay. So for example, so these two charges are separated by certain distance. What is the F21, F21 is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 Q1 Q2 divided by so R square into so this is R cap. So R cap is the unit vector. So that means force on second charge due to first charge. So here R12 means position of the first charge to second charge due to second charge. Position of the first charge due to second charge. So R12. So this is 1 to 2. This is 1. So this is 2. So 1 to 2. R12. So 1 to 2 means final position minus initial position. R12 is equal to R2 minus R1. So this is R2 minus R1 cap. So R2 minus R1 cap. So this is magnitude. So next direction. So 1 to 2. So 1, 2, 2. So that means R1, 2. So R1, 2. So R1 can be written as R2 minus R1. So R1, 2. R2 minus R1 can be written as. So R2 bar minus R1 bar divided by modulus of R2 bar minus R1. So here, so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q2 divided by R. So here, so modulus of R2 minus R1 is equal to R. So by using modulus, so this modulus is equal to R. So this distance is equal to H with R equal. So here modulus of R2 minus R1. So R2 minus R1 can be written as R2 bar minus R1 bar divided by so modulus of R2 minus R1. This is whole square. So therefore, so F21 bar is equal to so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r2 minus r1 whole cube 2 square equal cube into r2 bar minus r1. So this is also Coulomb's law in meter. So F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r2 minus r1 whole cube into r2 minus r1. So similarly, if you use the similarly, so you have to 1, 2. So you have to 1, 2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So you have to 1, 2. So this is, so in this direction, so this is R21. So that is equal to R1 bar minus R2 bar. So you have to 2, 1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1, 2, 2 by R2 minus R1 equal to into R2 bar minus R1 bar. So F12 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R1 bar minus R2 bar whole cube into R1 bar minus R2 bar. So this is the value of the F12. This is the Coulomb's law in metaphor. So F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R2 minus R1. So that is R2 minus R1. So here 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 divided by R1 minus R2 whole cube into R1 minus R2. So this is the Coulomb's law in vector form. I will discuss two methods. So if you select any one method, that means easy method. So as you wish. So as you wish, you select any one method. Okay. So next one. So note. So this is very, very important. This is very, very important note. So next one. Note. This is important. So first one. Q1, Q2 greater than 0. So Q1, Q2 is greater than 0. The product of two charges is greater than 0. That is same charges. So that is same charges. So here both are positive, positive, or both are negative, negative. So Q1 is the product of two charges is greater than zero. So that is same charges. So here do positive and negative and negative and negative. So plus into plus, plus minus into minus plus. So Q1 is greater than Q1 is greater than zero. So that is same charges. In this case, so force is repulsive. So repulsive force. So very, very important. So So in next one, second one, Q1, Q2 less than 0. So this is greater than 0. So this is less than 0. So Q1, Q2 less than 0. So that is unlike charges. So unlike charges. So one is positive, other one is negative. One is negative, other one is positive. In this case, the force is attractive. So this is attractive force. Okay, so these are very, very important. So Q1, Q2 greater than 0, that is same charges. So both are positive or both are negative forces. Repulsive. So Q1, Q2 less than 0, that is unlike charges. So positive into negative positive. So force is attractive. So greater than 0, force is repulsive. So less than 0, force is attractive. Okay, so next one. So principle of superposition. So next concept is principle of superposition. Principle of superposition. So principle of superposition. So this principle of superposition we are going to discuss more first here. So principle of superposition of waves. Okay, so same like that. So if there are three or more charges, so now if we take it, so for example, two charges now. So this is one charge, this is another. So one thing separated by certain distance. So what is the formula of force? Force is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So by using the Coulomb's law in electrostatics. So electrostatic force in between two charges is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So for example, three charges now, literally one charge. So does not applicable for the Coulomb's law. So two charges separated by certain distance, then find out the force by using Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law is applicable for the two point charges. So separated by certain distance. So in case three or more charges now, so Coulomb's law is not applicable. So Coulomb's law is applicable for more complicated. So Coulomb's law is applicable for more complicated in the case of the three or more charges. So in case of two charges, they are very applicable for Coulomb's law easily. Okay, so here two charges separated by certain distance are applicable for the Coulomb's law easily. So in case of three or more charges, so in the case of three or more charges, so for example, this is charge Q1. So this is Q2, so this is Q3, so this is Q4, and so on to get charges. So how to find out the force? So in case of two charges, by applicable directly Coulomb's law, okay, no doubt. So by applicable, by applying the Coulomb's law directly, so there is no doubt. So in the case of many charges, so number of charges, n charges, so Coulomb's law applicable for directly, it is more complicated. So in this situation, to overcome by introduce the principle of superposition. That means, so there are three or more charges. The net force on any one charge, the net force on any one charge is the vector sum of the all forces on it due to remaining charges. So this is the principle of superposition. Okay. So two charges separated by certain distance, there is no doubt. So by applicable for the Coulomb's law. So more charges they are there. Coulomb's law applicable molecule mass perspective. So avada, so easy to calculate molecule by using the principle of superposition. Okay. So what is the principle of superposition? If there are three or more charges, the net force on any one charge, the net force on any one charge is the vector sum of the all forces on it due to remaining charges. So that is the principle of superposition. Okay. So what is principle of superposition? So if there are three or more charges, so once observe this one. If there are three or more charges. So three or more charges. The net force on any one charge So any one charge is vector sum of all forces on it due to remaining charges. So this is the principle of superposition. Okay, so if there are three or more charges, the net force acts on any one charge is vector sum of all forces on it due to remaining charges. So this is the principle of superposition. So for example, so this is charge Q1. Okay. So this is charge Q2. So next, this is charge Q3. So next, this is charge Q4. So on and so on, Qn charges. Okay. So Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and so on, Qn. So here, so force acts on any one charge. So for example, now Q1 charge, mele force acts on any one charge. So force on Q1 charge. Okay. So force on Q1 charge is the vector sum of the all forces acts on this charge due to remaining charges. So here, by applicable for the Coulomb's law, in between two charges. So first applicable for the Q1, Q2. Okay, so these are separated by the distance is R1. So next, if you take the Q1, Q3, so these are separated by the distance is R1. So next, if you take the Q1, Q4, so this is R14 because of force on any one charge. Now I am selected Q1 charge. Force on Q1 charge is the vector sum of the all forces acts on the same charge due to the remaining charges. So this is the principle of superposition. So this is called the principle of superposition. So next one, so if we take Q1 charge, so this is equal to R1N. Okay, so if we select any one charge, the force acts on that charge is the vector sum of the all forces. So now we need the neutral supply model. If we take any two charges, Q1, Q2, separated by distances to R12, I apply Coulomb's law. So next, Q1, Q3, separated by distance R12. So by applicable for Coulomb's law. Next, Q1, Q4, separated by certain distance, by applicable for Coulomb's law. So either you do one doubt and a minor error. So ಈಗ ನಾವು q1 q2 ಈ ಎರಡು ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟು ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು q1 q2 ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡೇ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟು ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ q1 q2 ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ q1 q2 ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ Q1 and Q2. So this is the principle of superposition. Okay. So what is the principle of superposition? If there are three or more charges, the net force on any one charge. So the net force on any one charge is vector sum of all force acts on it. So if the L force on it, the charge will act on it, the Q1 charge. So therefore, so net force on Q1 charge. Net force on Q1 charge is equal to the vector sum of all forces acts on it. So remaining charges now use body act on a force no each charge will act. Okay, so that means so F12 force plus F13 force, F12, F13, so F14 and so on, F1n. So plus F14, so plus and so on, plus F1n. So this is the principle of superposition. Okay, so keep on your mind. So net force on any one charge. So I am selected Q1. So Q2 I am selected one. So remaining charge is the force of Q2 may act. So Q3 I am selected one. Q4 I am selected one. So if you select one charge, force on that charge is the vector sum of all forces act on it due to the remaining charges. So that is the principle of superposition. So Q1, Q2, separated by subdivisions R1, by accounting for the Coulomb sum. So F2, 1, 2 is equal to what is the formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught by accounting for the Coulomb sum. So two charges are there, now Coulomb sum will be. Okay. So this is the two discuss morning time, I keep it very important. These two charges separated by subdivisions R1. Remaining charges does not affect on these two charges. Okay, so F12 is equal to 1 by 4 by epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square. R12 square. So this is F12. So next F13. So Q1 Q3 separated by certain emissions as to R12. So F13 is equal to 1 by 4 by epsilon naught Q1 Q3. So Q1 Q3 divided by R13 whole square. So now we are going to discuss more in time. Remaining charges does not affect on this. Okay. So next to Q1, Q4. So force on first charge due to fourth. So that is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q4 divided by R14. So plus and so on. So and so on. So awesome. So F1 N is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 QL by R1 X square. So this is the principle of superposition. So very, very important, keep under mind. So what is the statement of principle of superposition? If there are two or more charges, the net force on any one charge is the vector sum of all forces on it due to the remaining charges. So, F net force acts on Q1 charge is equal to the vector sum of all forces acts on first charge due to the remaining charge. So, first charge. So, Q2 acting Q1. Q3 acting Q1. Q4 acting Q1. So, N charge acting on Q1. So, now select Q1 charge. So, if we select Q2, Q2, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q2, Q4, Q2, Qn. So for example, we start with Q3, Q3, Q1, Q3, Q2, Q3, Q4. So if force on any one charge, we can already see the net force on any one charge, not only first charge, not only second charge. So if we select any one charge, so force acts on any one charge is the vector sum of all force acts on it. So due to the remaining charges. So this is the principle of superposition. So very, very, very important. So keep on going. Next one, electric fields. So this is the one of the most important topic. So electric field. So next concept is electric field. Okay. Next one, electric field. Electric field. So what is electric field? So every charge creates electric field in the space around itself. So for example, I am here. I am here. So in this room. So I create my field around this room. So now what is something? So that is my field. So for example, if you take one charge. So here, this is charge. Placed in this space. Around this charge continuously electric field. So this is the electric field. Charge produced one person, this is electric. Electric means charge. So charge field. Charge model produced model field. So that is electric field. So every charge creates electric field in the space around itself. So that is the electric field. Okay. So that is the definition for electric field. The electric field means so every charge creates electric field in the space around itself, around itself. Around the itself. So this is the electric field. So every charge creates a field in the space around itself. So that is a. So for example, if we take charge, so this is the charge. So it creates the electric field. So each charge can make electric field create module. So what is the name of this charge? So this charge, say if we take positive or negative. So positive charge is what the negative charge is. So how many types of charge there are? Two types. One is positive, other one is negative. So other way, now think about it. Okay. So here only two charges is there. So one is positive charge, other one is negative charge. So here this charge is creates the electric field. So what is the name of this charge? So this is called a source charge. This is called source charge. Source charge always creates the electric field. Okay. So source charge always creates the electric field around itself in the space. Okay. So keep on. So next one. So if we take the another charge. So this is Q1. So what is the name of this charge? So this is called the test charge. So Q0 is called the test charge. So here test charge does not create any electric field. Only source charge creates the electric field. So Q0 is the test charge. So it does not create any electric field. Any electric field. So that means if Q0 tends to zero. So only source charge produces the electric field. Source charge either positive or negative. So here Q0 is the, what is the name of Q0? Test charge. So test charge does not create any electric field. So here, so test charge is always positive. So test charge is always positive. It does not create any electric field. Only produces the source charge. Okay. So this is very, very important. So source charge produces the electric field. So either positive or negative. So test charge is always positive. So it does not create any electric field. It does not create any electric field. Okay, so this is the electric field. Then next one. So next one. So this is the positive charge. For example, so this is the positive charge. Okay. Here this is called the source charge. So region around the electric field in the space. So when a test charge nearby the source charge, it can be produced as the electrostatic force. For example, so this is the source charge. This source charge is now, so test charge is used. So Q0 is called the test charge. So these two charges are separated by certain distance. They can be found the electrostatic force. So the region around the space. So when a charge, so region around the space gives a charge creates the electric field. So when another charge brought nearby the field, the electrostatic force is applicable in between two charges. Okay. So here positive. So here also positive. So this is repulsive. So here now if you make the test charge in this place. Okay. So test charge is always positive. So this is source charge. Now if you make the positive charge. So if it is positive, it is positive. So it is repulsive. So now here if you make this test charge. So here positive, here positive. So here the electrostatic force is act. So here test charge Q0. So here positive. Electrostatic force is there. So here test charge. So in the positive. So force of repulsion. So here also Q0 test charge. So in the positive, force of repulsion. So repulsion force is this charge. Okay. So the region around the space, When another test charge brought nearby the source charge, it experiences the electrostatic force. It experiences the electrostatic force. This is source charge nearby the test charge. So these two charges are separated by certain distance. Both are positive charges. So they can be formed the electrostatic force of repulsion. So electrostatic force of repulsion. So now is the positive charge is one. So positive charge use model and so electric field lines. So now you can draw the imaginary lines. Now we can draw the imaginary lines. So this imaginary lines is known as the electric field lines. So now if we take the positive charge, electric field lines are radially outwards. Radially outwards. So here about another example, if we take the negative charge. So next if we take the negative charge, so this is the source charge. Around this charge creates the electric field. So nearby the, so in this field, nearby using the test charge. So this is Q naught. So Q naught is always positive. So this is test charge. It does not create any electric field. Only source charge creates the electric field. So this is positive charge, this is negative charge. These two charges are separated by certain distance. So opposite charges, they are attracted to each other. So here attractive force is there. Okay. So now we are in this position. If we take Q naught test charge, so this is positive, this is negative. So electrostatic force of attraction. So here, electrostatic force of attraction. So in this electrostatic force of attraction. So in this point, so electrostatic force of attraction. So in this point, electrostatic force of attraction. So here, now if we take the negative charge, electric field lines are radially inwards. So now if we take the positive charge, now positive charge can be used for the other, electric field lines are radially outwards. So now negative charge used model primarily electric field lines now observe. So radially inwards. So radially inwards. Radially inwards. So very, very neat. So source charge creates electric field either positive or negative. But Q naught is a test charge, does not create any electric field. It is always positive. So it is positive, it is positive. Electric field is force of repulsion. So away from the charge. So here electric field is and now use model. Positive charge and now use model and the electric field is away from positive charge. Very, very important. So electric field is away from the positive charge. Electric field is away from the positive charge. So now if we take the negative charge, electric field is towards negative charge. So these are very, very, very important. So now positive charge can be used modulatively. Electric field away from the positive charge. And then negative charge can be used modulatively. Electric field is towards the negative charge. So these two points are very, very, very important. So positive charge is there, electric field is away from the positive charge. So negative charge is there, electric field is towards the negative charge. Okay. So this electric field, so this electric field extended is to infinity. This electric field, so electric field extended still infinity. So infinity number of lines are drawn. Okay. So electric field extended till infinity. So this is the electric field. So every charge creates electric field in the space around itself. So source charge is always creates electric field, either positive or negative. So now if we take positive charge, electric field is away from the positive charge. So next if we take negative charge, electric field is towards the negative charge. So test charge does not create any electric field because of it is always positive. So this value is Q naught tends to zero. So this is the electric field. So next one, electric field strength or electric field intensity. So electric field strength or electric field intensity. So next one. electric field strength. Electric field strength. Electric field strength ana intensity of electric field ana both are same. So intensity of electric field. Electric field. So it is denoted by E1. Okay. So we know that whenever there is such electric field, then we have to be an issue. Okay. So electric field strength or intensity of electric. So what is the definition for electric field strength or electric field intensity of electric? Electric field strength at a point is defined as electrostatic force experienced by the positive test charge at that point divided by the test charge. So that is called the intensity of electric or electric field strength. So what is the definition for electric field strength? Electric field strength at a point is defined as electrostatic force experiences by the positive test charge at that point divided by the test charge. Okay, so that is the electric field strength. So electric field strength, electric field strength is defined as electrostatic force acts on positive test charge at that point divided by test charge. So this is the definition for electric field strength. So that means electric field strength at any point in the field is defined as electrostatic force acts positive test charge at that point. For example, now electric field is so around this chapter is there. The chapter only one point only now intensity of the electric field part. So intensity of the electric field at any point in the field is defined as electrostatic force acts on the positive test charge. The positive test charge. The charge in the line of force. So force acts on positive test charge divided by the test charge. So this is called the electric field. So electric field E bar is equal to F bar divided by Q naught. So simple definition for electric field is E. So force experiences per unit positive test charge. So that is the simple definition for electric field strength. Okay. So force experiences per unit positive test charge is called the electric field strength or intensity of electric field. So intensity of the electric field E bar is equal to F bar divided by Q naught. So this is the formula for electric field strength or intensity of the electric field. So F Q naught is called the test charge. Test charge. So what is the definition? Electric field strength at any point in the field is defined as electrostatic force acts on a positive test charge at that point divided by the test charge. So this is the electric field strength or intensity of the electric field. So now we are using this one. So electric field intensity is a vector physical quantity. It is a vector physical quantity whose direction along the direction of force. So electric field direction is in the direction of the force. Electric field direction is in the direction of the force. So the electric field intensity is a vector physical quantity. So vector physical quantity is magnitude divided by direction. So what is the, in what direction is electric field strength or intensity? whose direction along the direction of the force. Direction of the force. Direction of the force. So it is a vector physical force. So next, SI unit. SI unit of electricity. So force measuring Newton. So charge measuring Coulomb. So what is the SI unit of electricity? Newton per Coulomb. Or another unit is volt per meter. So Newton per Coulomb is not to be like volt per meter. So this is the SI unit of the electric field strength. So next to dimensional formula. Dimensional formula. So what is the formula for electric field strength? Force divided by charge. So we know that what is the dimensional formula for force? Ampere e power minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula for force. Ampere e power minus 2. So next to charge. So charge dimensional formula is JT. So now substitute the value. So dimensional formula of electric field is equal to force divided by charge. So force dimensional formula will be mvr t power minus 2. So divided by charge. So charge dimensional formula will be 8. So this is equal to mvr t power minus 3 A inverse. So this is the dimensional formula for intensity of electric field. So intensity of the electric field dimensional formula is mvr t power minus 3 A inverse. So what is the SI unit of intensity of electric field? Newton per coulomb or volt per meter. Newton per coulomb or volt per meter. So Newton per coulomb or volt per meter. So this is the definition for intensity of the electric field. Okay. So now by using this formula, F is E is equal to F by Coulomb. So for example, when a charge placed in air. So for example, so this is the electric field. So this is the electric field. So here if we take the charge. So charge placed in the electric field. So charge is placed in the electric field. So force experiences by the charge. In this case, so force experiences by the charge is. So by using this formula, E is equal to F by Coulomb. Therefore, F is equal to Q naught into E. So this is the formula for force when charge placed in electric field. So when charge placed in electric field, what is the formula for force experienced by the charge? In the case of electric field, F is equal to Q naught into E. Okay. So F is equal to Q naught into E. So this is the formula for force. So this is the formula for electric field. So electric field is a vector physical quantity whose direction is along the direction of the force. So next, SI unit of electric field is Newton per Coulomb or volt per meter. So dimension formula is mvr t power minus 2. So force dimension formula is mvr t power minus 2. Charge dimension formula A into T. So therefore, finally, the dimension formula for electric field is mvr t power minus 3 A inverse. Okay. So this is the intensity of electric field. So next one. Electric field due to isolated point charge. Electric field due to isolated point charge. So next one. Electric field. Electric field. Due to isolated point charge. Isolated point charge. So this is also very, very important question. Also important formula. Okay. So electric field due to isolated point charge. So for example, this is the charge. So creates the electric field. So this is called the source charge. Source charge from source charge to smaller distance. So this is point P. So point P is at distance smaller from the source charge. Okay. So at point P, now if we take the test charge Q naught, so this is the test charge. So test charge does not create any electric field. Okay. So this is the source charge and this is test charge. These two charges are separated by some distance smaller. So by applicable for Ohm's law. So how? So what is Ohm's law? Ohm's law is applicable for two charges separated by certain distance. So some charge is positive charge. So next charge is also positive charge. So these two charges are separated by certain distance. So by using the formula for force of repulsion. Force to force one, so force of repulsion. So this is the repulsion. So force of repulsion. So by using Ohm's law, it is equal to so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2. So Q1 is the Q. So Q2 is Q0. These two charges are separated by certain distance is R. So according to Ohm's law, so F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2 naught divided by positive. So these two charges are positive. So force is in this charge. Okay. So according to intensity of the electric field definition, so E bar is equal to F bar divided by Q naught. So E bar is equal to F bar by Q naught. So now substitute the value. So E bar is equal to. So what is the value of F bar? So 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q. Small Q naught divided by R square into Q naught.